something more than night and day. First few nights, you never know, and then you get overconfident after a while and start making finding new mistakes. At least I do. I'll speak for myself. So we're going to do a wide variety of music, some older Stickmen pieces, like that piece, which is called Prague Noir, and we're going to do some newer. We have a brand new studio album and a new live album, which is very much what we're playing tonight. We'll do music from that, and of course, we'll throw in some King Crimson music, which I imagine some of you would love to hear. Here's a new piece of ours. This is called Ringtone.
Thank you. thank you. It doesn't get dry up here in the mountains. Let's see. That was ringtone, and somebody gave me a gift the other night for percussion, but I realized it's a wonderful little fan up here. I'll take advantage of that whenever I can. As you guys probably know, Tony plays the Chapman stick, and Marcus plays a similar instrument. He used to play a Chapman stick, and then he moved on, created his own instrument. I think the curious thing that you need to know is that either one of them could be the bass guy or the melody guy or the chord guy. To me, it's like they both got a piano. They're playing their strap and a piano up here. So you might think that Tony's always the bass player, but this next one's a good indicator because Marcus will be the primary bass player. He'll be the only bass player, I guess, on this one. And Tony will pick up the melody action and we'll carry on. Yeah, it's called Cusp.
Thank you. 10 years ago to record an orchestral piece in a theater somewhere around here. I don't remember its name, unfortunately. So it's nice to be back. Great to see all of you. We're going to play the first King Crimson cover song tonight. And it has, the title has three letters, R-E-D.
Thank you.
right, we're getting warmed up. Welcome back to you. Our new studio album I mentioned, that's called Tentacles, and we're going to play the title track from that. Should we say the story? So, we're about a year ago on semi-lockdown, so we can't get together. Marcus lives in Berlin. Pat lives in Austin. I live in New York State, upstate New York. Sometimes we can get together, but a year ago it wasn't so easy. So we were trading files and kind of in that creative, we were trading them in an unusual way, leaving space for the other guy to write in any tempo, with any time signature. And in that space, Marcus decided to give me a gift of it. I play the Chapman stick, he plays his self-designed U8. It's called the U8. And he decided to gift me one, and he shipped it over from Germany. While I was deep in the writing mode, and I told him, I emailed him that I'm going to get it, take it out of the case, put it into the studio, plug it in and play it. I don't even care what the tuning is. It would have gone out of tune. Indeed, it did in shipping. I still don't know what the tuning was, but I came up with a riff, and in my pathetic frenzy of writing, I thought, well, it's the U8. Let's tentatively call this piece U8 It, which is, from my youth, was a commercial for Alka-Seltzer. All great until Marcus pointed out to me that it wasn't the U8 at all. It had 10 strings, I hadn't counted, and it's the U10. And so we then gave up on that lousy title anyway, and went through a number of titles and ended up with the title Tentacles, came from that episode, and the whole album CD release became called Tentacles. Enough talk, here's the piece. We'll be playing the Chapman stick that I originally played on the U10.
Thank you. comes. Tick, 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 tick.
In Austin, a little bit outside of Boston, in 2010. And that was the 10-year anniversary. He was referring to the gift that Marcus gave him for the last piece we just played. The next piece, though, is the first piece we did there. Was called Crack of the Sky. It was an instrumental when we first did it. And then later, Tony had written a poem for or about Alan Holdsworth, and that got appended onto this piece. And it's called Crack of the Sky. We got good water up here, lots of it, I guess. Yeah, what are we playing here? This is the trip that Tony made a few years ago. Like he mentioned, the last record was mostly file sharing, but previous to that, Marcus would come over and work up at Tony's house in New York. And a year or two after that, the Prague Noir record, Tony had gone over to Berlin, I think in January or February, early in the year, and Marcus keeps describing how dark and gloomy and gray it can be in Berlin. And that was what Tony said, the taste of what he had there when they created the beginning of this record. And Tony insisted that it have at least one German title. And this is a tune with the German title. And it's somewhat untranslatable.
Well, it basically just means dark and gloomy, so. But it's a funny word, it's Schattenhaft.
And we're gonna segue after that, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we're gonna segue. Go ahead,
Tom. Can I give a tip to any? I have a feeling there are quite a few musicians in the audience. My experience is when the other guy in the band says he's gonna tune, you better tune up yourself. He might just be being polite and kind of letting you know that you're the one. Just thought I would share that.
That's like the old, am I rushing there?
And I was, I think.
Okay. Yeah, so we're going to segue into an old Robert Fripp piece that wasn't played very much. It's off his Exposure record. Oh, I don't think they're Schattenhaft.
Thank you.
So we're going to take it down. See you in a few minutes.
Welcome back. So we have a little, you know, something very special for you tonight. We're going to play something that's not a full piece yet. It's just an idea we had. We started, you know, playing. I think we maybe played 3-4 times on this tour only, and just to see what it's like to play in front of people. The working title is Vincent.
This is the one you can clap with. Help us see the intro and the outro. But the deal is, you're gonna clap in three, like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Can you do that shit? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Bop, 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 like a Texas waltz. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Bop, 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 bop. Okay, so you sort of got that. And then we clap in twos, like a German disco. Here's the routine. 3-3-2, 3-3-2-2, 3-3-2-2-2. I'm serious. Then we do it backwards. 2-2-3, 2-2-3-3, 2-2-3-3-3-2-2-3-3-3. It's like dialing for dollars, like a good old telephone. It's a challenge. And if you're really on top of it, you can try to clap the beats in between. We've had a few cats that do that. But We'll try to play it correctly to you. And we do it twice, like I say, once at the top, again at the end. I'll warn you at the very end, we throw away the last two threes. It just felt right. For you people in the dark, you could just go for it, because we'll never have any idea if you got it right or wrong. And we've messed it up plenty ourselves. So 3-3-2, 3-3-2, 2-3-3, 2-2-2, 2-2-3, 2-2-3, 2-2-2, 3-3-3, 3-3-3. Except for the last time. Okay. We'll be right back.
question. And we did it not bad too. There were hard nights that we scored. I don't know. A rare night that somebody in the audience just aces it and gets it all right, so don't worry about that. And here's, if we put this kind of symbolic pressure on you on that piece, I don't think we did, but if we did, you have your revenge on this next piece. Certainly, for me, the hardest piece of the new material. What's the live, the name of the...
Omeda. Omeda.
Omeda is the live album that we're hoping you're interested in. We'll come out and sign after the show if anybody gets it. It's pretty much this show, and I think I played this piece sort of right on that. But musicians, if there's musicians out here, maybe you know this, what it's like. You see the set list, and then there's one piece fairly near the end that, uh-oh, I'm worried about that one. That's where I make all my mistakes. So this is that piece. And I'm not worried, I'm embracing the fear of this piece. Embrace the fear. And the best part by far is that it happens by coincidence to have the completely appropriate title. This is called Danger in the Workplace.
Thank you. Black ones. God left that place.
get a sip of water here, okay.
Actually, this is going to be the last song of the regular set.
Oh.
And it's kind of funny to me, because this piece that we just played, I wrote when I was like 15. That was 5 years before I discovered these guys, the music of King Crimson. So as the last piece, then I'm going to give you something that was written in 1972. So the year of my birth, actually. And it's called Lark's Tense and Aspen Part 2.
Thank you.
Shanghai, and the tour would continue into Japan, but that didn't happen because COVID happened. But we'd already gotten on a plane and headed over, and we were meeting with Gary Husband, fantastic keyboard player and drummer, and we were going to do a series of gigs with Gary. We ended up doing one gig, and that was, they shut the Japan down. We were lucky, we were the last international band to get in and play a gig before they shut it all down. And we recorded that show, we did two sets, and I believe it's called Awari, if I'm pronouncing it close to correctly. And that is available at the merch. And we've got these other live records because what Leonardo, our merch man, does is he scouts into Tony's garage and he finds things. Tony doesn't even know he has these things. He found another box of live record we did called Unleashed, which was, I think, all improvised stuff, wasn't it? I think early on we used to do quite a bit of improvising in the show. And let's think. He sold out of your Bleed record, but he's got your Anchor and Burden record still, which is one of Marcus's side projects, or main projects at different times, I'm sure. And he's got one called Sun Trance, which is pretty cool. It's an orchestral piece. A friend of mine did some of the drumming on there, so I'm proud of that. He put you don't put it to plastic anymore. You put it to disc or whatever, to a download. So that's all over there with our t-shirts. And Tony had a series of books, which are all gone, but he does have, he's got the Levin Brothers. I don't know if you know, Tony's brother is a wonderful keyboard player, and they toured together as the Levin Brothers, the softer side of Tony. It's, you know, kind of more piano trio, well, you're a quartet, I think most of the time. I haven't actually got to see it, but I do have the record. It stays in the car, comes up in rotation in the car. And there's another one back there called Tony's Picks, which I thought were photographs, but they're selections Tony has put together on a CD of other projects he does besides Peter Gabriel and Pink Floyd and Crimson and all that stuff. And I have a couple records back there with some Italians. It's called Ork, O-R-K, actually. And it's with Colin, the bass player that was with Porcupine Tree. And we've got Serge from System of the Down singing on the third record, Blackwell. Adam Jones from Tool did the artwork for both of the last two. And the last one is called Screamnasium. It's the Green Skull. Yeah, and that's a nice segue to the fact that during COVID, we all kept busy. And my wife, who saw her first Crimson show in 2008, went into the bathroom, said there was a woman with her head in the sink going, "Oh my God, make it stop." And my wife, my girlfriend, then she came to me later and she said, "You know, honey, if your band would just smooth out the edges." I said, no. We'll give you Walking on Air, and then we're going to give you Thrack, you know.
Let's not forget to mention Tentacles. Tentacles, the EP this tour is based on, and that's for sale. And when we're done, we'll go to the dressing room for a minute and then come out to wherever that table is with the merch and sign anything you have or take photos or things like that.
And so my wife had an appointment during COVID, we were locked down together. So we made the softer King Crimson record. We tried to take some of the classics and orchestrate them into like tangos and a little softer. Well, actually, she did one of them as the 1-800 porn line. I don't know if you've ever listened to the record, Tony. Elephant Talk is a whole new selection of words that start with E. Anyway, I'm segueing into what we're about to play, our last couple pieces here. The first will be a softer Crimson piece that came off the Discipline record, and then we'll follow that with a more brutal piece that came off the Power to Believe record. Thank you all very, very much for coming on Tony Sessler.